Hey, what's going on, everybody? This is Mike at HiFiInsider.com. Today, I have a brand new product to share with you. Another new product from iFi Audio. This is the iFi iDSD Signature Series. This line of product from iFi Audio, the iDSD, has gone through a few generations. I reviewed for you guys the original, and then they came out with the black label, and now we have the signature. So we're going to take a look around the box and see some of the features, and I'll give you an overview of the product, and then I'm going to spend some quality ear time with it, and I'll give you guys my full review in another video. Alright, so let's go ahead and unwrap this first. I will need my trusty blade. Alright, before we move on, I want to thank my friends at iFi Audio for sending this out to me on loan for review. I appreciate their support of the channel. So, let's take a look around the box first. We have the MQA label. This is MQA fully supported. I personally am not a fan of MQA, but I do see some people like it using Tidal. So this is fully supported. And then we have the Burr Brown DAC, which I like a lot because Burr Brown, I think their sound signature is very natural and smooth. And then you got their proprietary turbo amp technology, MQA, the balance technology. They have their S balance. And then around the side here, we have a picture of the amp, and then you have a USB-C connector. And then around the back, you have some description about the DAC amp. So you can read about that on the website. And here are the specifications. Now, just looking at the numbers here, it looks to be a very powerful amplifier, but I do want to bring up that you shouldn't buy anything based on the specifications alone, because there's no industry standard on how the specifications are achieved. So every manufacturer can be very different. And I do recommend you make a purchase decision based on the reviews that you've seen and also customer comments and things like that, but don't buy anything based on the specifications alone, like you would, on a computer. And in my opinion, especially on a computer, the specifications does not tell you how it will perform. How the software optimization is actually more important than what the specifications are. And I learned that firsthand behind a Windows computer. So anyhow, we can talk about that if you guys want to hear my opinion about that. Let me know in the comments. So you're greeted by the unit itself, and we'll take a look at that in a few. I always like that iFi gives you a lot of accessories in the box, so you don't have to go out and buy it separately. So here looks to be a quick start guide, and you should take a look at that just to get yourself familiar with all the inputs and outputs. You get a carrying pouch. Some rubber bands to strap your player to the amplifier. An audio pair of audio cables. USB 3.0 extension cable, a optical Toslink adapter, haven't seen these in a while, a protection pad for use when you put your music player on top of the iDSD so it doesn't scratch either of the units, a 3.5mm to 1/4 inch 6.3mm adapter, and I'd like to say that this is a very low profile adapter. So here's the star of the show. Beautiful. I really like the machine work on the iDSD products. I think it's very, very nice quality. So you have a standard unbalanced 1/4 inch output, 4.4 balance output. Now they have these S balance circuitry to convert the unbalanced to balance. I'll put a link in the description about the technology of this S Balance so you can read more about that. And you have some features like the X Bass 3D, and then there's a on off and volume knob. On the side here, you have the USB-C charging port. And around the back, this is a combo jack, 3.5mm analog and optical toss link. And then there are the RCA outputs. The digital input, because you can connect the Lightning to USB adapter from Apple directly to this without any additional cabling. So the signal path is very, very short. I really like that. And there are some switches here which are labeled around the bottom here. You have the IEM match for sensitivity IEM. So if you have an in-ear monitor that is very sensitive, like my Westone W80, this is a good match for that. And then you get some filtering for the digital. And then the Pert Turbo and Normal and Equal power mode for power demanding headphones. And I like the new integrated pads, so you know, it's not just those sticky pads. And you got a ton of logos here. This is like an AV receiver, so many logos, but it's pretty cool. And then some information about the signature edition. Now I wish the text was in white so it's easier to read. I mean, I have pretty good eyes, but it's rather difficult to read the text. Just look at the machine work here. It's just very, very nice, especially at this price. Definitely a lot of features for the money. I like that it's battery operated, so I don't have to plug it into the wall, take up another outlet. So this channel has no advertisement support from manufacturers or sponsorship, and there's no Patreon where you can support the channel. But I do hope that you guys will use my Amazon link in the description to support the channel. And I'll put a link to iFi Audio's website as well so you can read more about the specifications and the features. And thanks for watching, everyone. I really appreciate the support, and I'll see you guys again in my next video. Bye-bye.